All right, check it out. This is going to be the first official 1,000-pound club challenge for Bravo Company. So the way it works is the sum of your lifts, your squat, your bench press, and your deadlift have to be equal to or greater than 1,000 pounds. The events are in order. We're going to do the bench press first, followed by the deadlift, and then followed by the squat. So after this, we're going to break it down and show you what you're looking for, what cues. You're going to have a coach at each event. All right, so how it's going to work is you're going to have 3 attempts for each lift. So everyone will go through once. After that, we'll do the second iteration, the third iteration. What I recommend to do is for your first attempt, set it to a weight where you can do 2 or 3 reps. So maybe your second attempt will be your gym PR, and then your third attempt will be a PR that you're trying for or shooting for. That makes sense? So I've been sick for the last week. I know tomorrow I'm gonna wake up with no voice. But I've been trying to put this 1,000-pound club together for the company for the past 2 weeks. Just for like, it's a morale boosting event. Everyone was loving it. Everyone's like cheering each other on. It was something the guys wanted to do. So don't look at those videos and critique their form, because a lot of them don't lift on a regular basis. We had a few classes leading up to this event on how to improve your deadlift and your squat and your bench press and cues to look out for the form. But overall, they enjoyed it. They did a really good job. There were 8 guys that made the 1,000-pound club, but it's something we're going to do every 2 months to kind of just make sure people are improving, or give them like a baseline of where they need to improve on, what they need to work on in the gym. But it was a good experience. They all had a good time. So this is tonight's bedtime snack. I have a 6-mile ruck march tomorrow morning, which I need to be ready for. So plenty of sleep. I will see you guys at the ruck march. You can see by my eyes that I am currently under the influence of pre-workout. So right now we're working up to the goal of doing a 25-mile ruck march by the end of the deployment. And a lot of the guys that came to the platoon got here right before coming to Korea. So they don't have a lot of experience with ruck marches or miles under their feet. So we're slowly building up onto ruck marches and adding more weight and more miles and different routes. But this morning, the one that I chose was off post, and it was essentially a 45-degree incline straight up for like 2 miles. People were broke off and falling out, but it was a crazy good workout. So I'm about to hit the gym right now. I'm gonna do a shoulders and arm workout. I'll show you that intraflight right here. Let's go. All right, guys, so this past week I posted something on Twitter, and it was in regards to strength does not equal mass and size does not equal strength. And it kind of ties into yesterday with the 1,000-pound club challenge with the company, because all these bigger guys whose training typically revolves around moderate weight with higher reps, 8 to 15, came into the gym, they set their openers, and they expected PRs that they've never attempted before. And they just assumed that because they were bigger, they had more muscle, that they were gonna be stronger than most. And this isn't the case in most situations. You know, you see bigger guys come in the gym and they muscle up the weight because their form isn't on point. They're not very efficient at the lift itself. And this is something I want to talk about, because the way my training set up, and you guys probably see it, is it has a mix between strength and hypertrophy. So I'll usually start off each workout with some sort of compound movement, whether that be squat, bench, or deadlift. And I'll focus on lower reps with a higher weight. And then afterwards, I'll go into more volume and hypertrophy, because I like a mix of the two. I like getting stronger and more efficient at the lifts to get better, but I also like putting on muscle and that bodybuilding aspect of it. And I found a balance between the two that works out really well for me and that I'm really enjoying. But I'd say the biggest differences between strength training and hypertrophy training is hypertrophy and bodybuilding. That's just getting a lot of volume into the muscle, the blood flow, breaking down the muscles and for recovery. And you can do it more frequently. But with strength training, it's a skill. That's the best way to describe it. Strength training is a skill that you learn, you master, and the more frequently you do it and practice it, the better you get at it. And this is something I really didn't realize in college because I was putting on a lot of size, but I wasn't getting stronger, and I just assumed that I naturally wasn't a strong person. But that's not the case. Strength is something you need to master and do more often to get better at. And the more efficient you become at the lift itself and eliminate unnecessary movements and variables, the more weight you can move. And it's not just muscle that moves weight, it's neural adaptation and recruiting all these motor units and neurons that function and sync at once. And when they move and function at once, they can move more weight because they're more efficient. And the more often you do it, the more motor units you recruit, and your body gets used to just lifting that weight, and it almost snaps, and it's able to move that weight more often, more efficiently. And in regards to bodybuilding, and where it really differs is bodybuilding, you're moving a lot of weight over and over again. The form might be on point, but the body isn't used to throwing up these huge numbers and these large loads for lower reps. So whatever you want to gear your training towards or master, you can incorporate both styles of training. But just keep in mind that if you want to get stronger and you want to increase your strength, you need to work with these heavier loads for lower reps so your body can adapt to it and get ready to function at once.
It's a big hat kind of day.
Big hat day!
So I've been getting a lot of questions on how to prepare for like basic training or how to improve your runtime. And I'll kind of just tell you what our platoon's doing right now. The plan I devised in order to improve our overall scores or our platoon average. So once a week we do like a 4 to 5 mile run, which is our longer, slower distance run, and we'll go into ability group runs. So we'll run probably at I'd say 8 minute per mile pace, just trying to cover some distance. And then our second run of the week is a track workout. So on this one, we're trying to improve our VO2 max. If you're not aware what VO2 max is, it's the amount of oxygen your lungs and your body can handle in a minute. So to improve your VO2 max, it's primarily genetic that determines your ability to run and handle oxygen. But you can improve your VO2 max in a workout like a track workout. So you're running intervals, typically shorter distances, but you're running at a pace that is faster than your 1 mile split time, if that makes sense to you guys. So we do one long run, which is like a pace run, and then our second track cardio workout in the week is a higher intensity VO2 improvement workout. And then our last one is like a ruck march once a week. So tonight I have to work from 10 p.m. until 2 a.m. I have to be in the barracks presence and just make sure no one's getting in trouble. So I should be leaving work here soon. All right, work day is over, and we luckily have a Monday off, so 3-day weekend this weekend. Super, super excited about. I'll tell you, man, the thing I miss most about being home right now is my dog, Leroy. If you're a new subscriber, you haven't seen him in recent videos because I'm in Korea, obviously, and he's back at home in Texas staying with a friend. But I was reading an article today about like the relationship between someone and their dog, and it's crazy true. You get attached to your dog, and I miss my dog a lot. So, General Order 1 was lifted today. Soldiers can drink again and go off post. That's why I'm going to be in the barracks tonight for some responsible presence in case people come back a little too intoxicated. I can handle that mess. But that's going to wrap up the video, guys. I appreciate the support as always. Thanks for watching. And I'll talk to you or see you or you'll see me in that next video.